the other day she came out.
Oh, yeah. Never mind.
What the schedule says, please.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, I'm doing great. Has Mr. Richard Perdue come out?
Not yet. I'm Ben Ayers.
Ben, I'm
okay. Yeah. He is not. So, who are you with, press?
Okay. My name is Nick.
Okay.
You have a call on?
No problem.
You need to get a photograph of this.
Yeah, sorry, we just have a lot of.
I'm not attacked.
Yeah.
Actually, I just put it up.
How you doing?
Today, we really appreciate having you here at Burt's Farm. I think we're ready to get this show on the road today, get everyone that you came to see, let them start talking and kind of giving you an update about this strong Republican ticket that we have this year. Just very quickly want to give extra special thanks, as always, to Johnny and Kathy Burt and the entire Burt family for allowing us to have this event here at Burt's Farm. For all the hospitality that they've extended. So thank you very much to Johnny and Kathy and the entire Burt family. It's really an honor. You know, this is something that many of you that are here were here 5 years ago in August of 2009 when Congressman Deal was running for governor. So it's really great to be here 5 years later and obviously helping to work reelect him to a much deserved second term. So we're glad to have everyone here today. One quick note of announcement. They do have pumpkin pie and pumpkin rolls and lots of drinks, so help yourself to that. There are restrooms at the end of this building if you need to use the restroom. And then as you came in, y'all may have seen that gigantic pumpkin that was out there. That's the door prize for today. So after the governor speaks, before everyone leaves, we'll announce who's the door prize winner, and somebody's going to get to take home a giant pumpkin, because it wouldn't be a pumpkin farm without a giant pumpkin. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to our insurance commissioner, Mr. Ralph Hudgens. We're really glad to have Commissioner Hudgens with us today. He's done a great job on the ballot this fall, and we'll let Commissioner Hudgens go from there. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you for being here today. Thank you for helping us reelect the complete Republican ticket. I tell you, for the first time ever, we've got a Republican in every office, and we need to keep it that way. In the insurance world, my battle right now, really not my battle, but what I get accused of having a battle is Obamacare. But let me tell you, Obamacare is a total, total disaster. It, if you want to get a quick glimpse of what Obamacare is going to result in if we don't repeal it, look at what's happening in the Veterans Administration. That's exactly what's going to happen with us if we don't repeal this. Now, I'm not saying let's just repeal it and do away with it. We need to repeal it and replace it. And there are some, Congressman Price, Tom Price from Georgia, has a wonderful plan, but we need to take an incremental approach to this problem we have with health care. We don't need an omnibus bill that does everything in the world like this one tried to do. You know, the president has delayed in this bill 71 different times. He has said, well, this is what the bill says, and then he changes his mind and he delays it. Governor, that doesn't happen in our state. I was in the legislature for 14 years. Every time we passed a bill, then we sent it to the governor. If the governor signed it, then it became law, and we expected the agency that it applied to uniformly enforce that bill and do what it says. But President Obama says that, well, I don't like this part, so we're going to delay it, and I think it's time we call his hands. I hope that I see our nominee for Senator David Perdue back here. We've got to elect David to help us get the majority in the U.S. Senate. If we can get the majority in the Senate and maintain the majority in the House, which we will, Congressman Collins is here.
I'm right.
Wherever he is. There he is. He's doing a great job. But we can maintain that majority, get the majority in the Senate. Then we can call his bluff. Right now, Harry Reid is being an absolute obstructionist on everything that is a good piece of legislation. And we need to do our part. The only part we can do is to make sure that David Perdue is elected and Michelle Nunn is not. And I'm not going to get into that race, but I was at the I was at the Chamber of Commerce event where David and Michelle had a debate, and I have never seen anybody misrepresent their stands as much as Michelle Nunn did. She absolutely, all she wanted to do is talk about, we need to have a team, we need to have consensus building, we need this and that. And I thought I was going to have to resuscitate my wife. I thought she was going to pass out, and I thought I was going to absolutely puke listening to her. I mean, I don't know why you're videotaping, but yes, I said that. Anyway, I'm running for re-election. I have two opponents. I have a lady that she ran for insurance commissioner in Florida. She lost that. Then she moved to Georgia. She ran for state rep against John Burns. She lost that. Then she ran for chairman of the county commission in Bullock County. She lost that. Then she ran for clerk of court in Bullock County, and she lost that. And I was telling a campaign consultant about her record, and his response is, boy, she's due. And I said, no, Michael, that's not what I'm looking for. I want to keep her string alive. But the funny one was, I was on the 14th floor of the West Tower, and a guy was up there, and he said, aren't you Ralph Hudgens? And I said, I am. He said, well, I'm, and I can't remember his name for the life of me, but he introduced himself. He said, I'm running against you for insurance commissioner. I said, you are? I said, what brought that on? He said, well, I used to be a Republican. I got real disenfranchised with what they were doing. And so I started going to the Libertarian Party meetings. I was at the Libertarian Party meeting in Cobb County. They were going over their candidate list, and they said, we need somebody to run for insurance commissioner. He said, well, I've got 22 years experience as an agent. They said, good, you're our candidate. That's the way he's in there. But I need to get over 50% of the vote. With your help, that'll happen. And with your help, we'll be able to keep our Republican ticket. And I want to introduce a friend of mine, Richard Woods. Richard is who I supported in the primary because he was opposed to Common Core, and I'm opposed to Common Core, and so I supported him. But Richard Woods is our the candidate for school superintendent, and let's give him a warm Dawson County welcome.
Well, again, one of the good things here that if Mr. Hudgens does lose his cookies, I've worked at an elementary school, so I have experience that I can come in behind and make sure everything's taken care of. My name is Richard Woods, and again, I can honestly say I am not in South Georgia. This is a beautiful part of the state, but I do live in Tifton, Georgia, so I'm about four and a half miles south of here. But it is a privilege to be the Republican nominee for state superintendent of schools. And as your next state school superintendent, again, one of the things I can assure you is that I do bring experience to this office. Again, for 22 years, I worked in the Irwin County school system, working 14 years as a classroom social studies teacher and 8 years in administration, working from assistant principal, principal, K-5 curriculum director, and the list goes on and on with that. But again, everything was pre-K through 12th grade at the school level. So, things that I talk about come from firsthand experience. And because I have that firsthand experience, one of the things we look at is that what are we going to do for our children, and what are we going to do for our school system to make sure that each child has the opportunity to succeed. Well, first thing, we are going to be child-focused, and that means we are going to make sure that we personalize and not standardize education, because our children, there is not one size fits all. They are completely different, and we need to have the flexibility to take our children where they are at and move them forward. And that is my commitment to do that, because if we fail the children, honestly, we have failed in education. So that will be the primary focus to do that. But in order to make sure that we are personalize our education system, that means we've got to go to our teachers. And we've got to allow our teachers to once again do the job that they went to school to do. And we do that by reducing and eliminating unnecessary paperwork, data collecting. And instead of teaching to the test, we teach to the child. Again, coming from a period of with No Child Left Behind, which I worked very diligently with, all we heard about was the test, the test, the test. Well, at that point, we began to miss the important thing in education, where it should be about the child, the child, the child. And in doing that, by focusing on our teachers and our kids, that means we concentrate on our classroom. By concentrating on the classroom, we will make sure that our kids, by the time they leave fifth grade, they will be proficient in reading, writing, and math, because those are the foundational skills that build on everything else that goes on beyond that point. For myself as a high school social studies teacher, content was not an issue. But the issue that I had was that our kids needed to read and read in comprehension. And as your next state school superintendent, my commitment is to make Georgia the number one literate state in our nation. Because if we can teach our kids to read, if they can have that foundation, the doors of opportunity will be boundless to them. And so we will do that. But also being a foundationist, that means that we'll do some things that we look at, that we make sure that our kids understand and appreciate our great, rich history. We will teach history and be more diligent with that. We will teach the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, the Federalist Papers, all the great works that we have. We will not leave that out, because I firmly believe that as our children leave high school and in Georgia education, if they understand it's better to be independent from and not dependent on government, we have done a great thing. Because that means we will have citizens that will begin to build on our capitalistic, system we have as far as economics, but also they will remember and cherish, what has made America great. And that is something that we have to do that is very, very important. Again, I also need your help. And again, please go to my website, woodsforsuper.com, and visit there, but join us on Facebook and Twitter, because, I still do math the old-fashioned way. And what I understand is that I'm just one individual, but you out here, 10 people who know 10 people who know 10 people. And so we have to get that message out that we have the best plan and we have the best organization for us. And now I would like to introduce our current and our next Commissioner of Labor, or Secretary of Labor, Mark Butler. So again, appreciate that.
I don't think they gave me enough link here to work with. I like to move around. Y'all excited about this election?
Yeah.
All right, we need you to be. This is a very important election. Got a lot to talk about. First of all, I want to kind of give everybody a kind of example about the difference between a Democrat-run Department of Labor and a Republican run the Department of Labor. When I got there, we had a very, very bloated Department of Labor. We had what I thought was way too many employees. So we said, you know what? The people elected me to give you efficient government. And we've done that. We've reduced our workforce, not positions, that's the difference. Some people are tricky with that. I'm talking about people there. We've reduced our positions by 31%. We have 650 less people working at Department of Labor today than we had 3.5 years ago. And the good thing about that is, it seems like that'd be bad, but guess what? We're actually doing a better job today than we were doing 3.5 years ago, because we're concentrating on getting people a job, not an unemployment check, because that's what it's really about. Now, there's been a lot of talk here recently about, you know, oh, Georgia is going the wrong direction. Well, let's talk about that really quick. Now, I'm going to kind of give you the numbers, and the governor's going to tell you a little bit more about it in just a minute. But let's just talk about this latest little bump in the unemployment rate. You know, little Mr. Carter, he is very upset right now about the unemployment rate. He's very concerned about the job loss we've seen over the last 3 months. But guess what? He's not telling you the whole story. Anybody like to guess which private sector has lost jobs over the last 3 months? That's not private sector. You pretty much answered it. It has not been any private sector job loss. The job loss comes from 45,000 jobs lost.
What is your name? What is your name? What is your name? Sir, what is your name? What is your name, sir? Identify yourself. What is your name? What is your name? Let go of me. What is your name, sir? Let go of me. I spoke with the owner prior to this beginning. No, Mrs. Burts, Kathy Burts, said it was okay. Mr. Let go of me, sir. Mrs.
Stop.
Let go. Let me get my purse.
No, you're going to jail.
Let me get my purse. I need to show you my ID anyway. Sir.
Yep.
You need to identify yourself.
I've been real nice. Now you're going to jail for resisting arrest. You do not stop.
Will you please stop, man? We've asked you multiple times.
Positively on Twitter to help get people here. I am sorry that people are treating you this way. This is wrong.
You've been asked to stop. Listen, I'm not taking you to jail. Understand me? Do you know what I'm saying?
Please say it for yourself. Please tell me.
I'll be happy to as soon as you stop. Stop.
I want to know who you are and what your name is.
And I'll be happy to tell you.
She's doing. I tried to work with her. Tried to talk to her.
I spoke with several candidates and they didn't mind. I spoke with the owner. I spoke with Kathy Burts.
Listen, I'm the owner and I said no.
Mrs. Burts said me said it was okay. Kathy Burts said it was okay. I spoke to her when I first arrived. I spoke with Kathy Burts and she said it was okay.
And then I come spoke with you and told you the owners did not want you to do that. You can record all you want, that's fine. And then you resisted. And then you resisted some more. And then you fought with me.
I didn't fight with you. You're the one who has grabbed me. This was a public event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal. Kathy?
You just talked to the owner who asked you to leave, who's told you you couldn't do this here, and you're still
okay,
in there.
Okay, I'll leave.
No, you're leaving now, you're going to jail. You've resisted me, my lawful duties, trying to get you to cooperate. You didn't want to do that. You fought with me, you've wrestled with me, so we're just going to wait and you're going to go to jail. I don't know what else to do with you. I tried to talk to you, I tried to explain.
Please loosen your grip, I'm not going anywhere.
As soon as you decide to act like you're somebody and stop fighting with me.
I'm sorry, sir, what did you say?
So as soon as you stop fighting with me,
I'm not fighting, I'm not resisting
you. You're not now because I'm not giving you a choice anymore, but you fought me the entire way over here and continued to fight with me. I don't know you, I don't know what you have on you, and I don't like it when I tell you to stop doing something and you continue to do it. I don't know what you have in that bag.
I don't know you either. You have not given me your name, sir.
And I'll be happy to. You'll see it on the warrant when we get to jail.
Tell me your name, sir, and show me your badge.
You've seen my badge.
No, I haven't, actually.
Yes, you have.
I didn't.
Yes, you have.
You did not see...
Yes, you have.
Please, sir, let go.
Stop resisting. You keep saying you're being nice for your camera. Stop resisting.
Mrs. Burt's. I spoke with her in advance.
Ma'am.
I told her I was here. I was. I
you
have my camera.
You just had the owner of
film.
The place, Johnny Burt.
Okay, let go, let go, let go, sir. Ow! That hurts. You're hurting me.
Stop.
You're hurting me.
Stop.
You are really hurting me.
Stop.
You are hurting me.
All you gotta do is be still. You